Christian Black site where we break, obliterate, and overcome our mountain. Today, the Lord laid it on my heart, just really go and have a mental health day, which is something we need to do daily. There's so many things competing for our minds. There's so many things competing for our heart. There's so many things competing for our attention. There's so many different things just we're grappling with. And the Lord just said on my heart, you know what? Do something that you normally don't do. Just go and enjoy. I had a lot of different things to do today, but after I was on my way home, I said, the Holy Spirit said, go sit by the water and just spend some time with me. And so I did that today. And one thing that he spoke to me about as I was sitting by the water, and if you can look over my shoulder, this is just so awesome. I thank God to just live in New Rochelle so we can have an opportunity to just go sit by the water because of where we're located. But one of the things that he laid on my heart today was, you know, I look at these houses, and if you can see behind me, there are some really gorgeous houses. And you see the people in their homes, and they're coming out, and they just get to enjoy, I guess, the fruit of their hands. And my husband and I, we really like to go, and we really, and my family, my daughters, we like to go by the water. We like to look at different things, and we like to dream a little bit. And not a little bit, a lot. And there's a lot that I have on my heart that I want to be able to accomplish in the earth. The one thing that, as I was looking at the houses, I thought, oh, they're so beautiful one day. And God said to me, you know, you can do a lot of stuff in the earth. You can reach the mountaintops of your career. You can reach the mountaintops in wealth. You can reach the mountaintops in just different aspects of your life and all of your getting. But if you do that and you have yet to pursue my heart, if you have yet to chase after me in your everything, you can have that house and be standing in it and be empty. And so the most important thing in life is not getting that house. It's not getting that wealth. It's not getting that social status. It's not getting accepted by, you know, the elites. It's not having the $1 million bank account, although that would be nice. All those things are nice in its place. And so what God has reminded me today is all that stuff doesn't matter, because only the things you do for Christ will last. So we spend a lot of our times scratching and clawing to get somewhere in the earth. Although we do need to make money, although we do want to, you know, reach certain goals in our life, build businesses and do this and do that, and I'm with you with that. But God is, he's changing the narrative in my mind on that is not what's important. What is important is pursuing my heart. And if you pursued my heart, and if you pursued my presence, and if you pursued my gifts, and you have chased after me, that is the life that's worth living. All that other stuff will come. But if I have not been the first priority, or if you're seeking other things and you haven't gotten the place where you need to be with me, all those things are gonna be empty. And at the end of the day, when we close our eyes, they're gonna burn up in fire. Only the things we do for Christ will last. And so I'm reminded today, and just wanna encourage you, that in all of our getting, the most important thing we can ever do in this life, and Ecclesiastes is really clear on what's important. When Solomon was chasing after this and chasing after that, and, you know, trying to get this and trying to get that and finding out what was good, at the end of the day, his number one conclusion is to enjoy the work of your hands, to do good for others, and to love God. And so if that's our priority, we're on the right track. But if our priorities are shifted and just solely getting what the world says is important, then our priorities need to be lined back up with God. And so God is realigning what's important in my life. And that's Him. And so if I never get accepted into a social club, or if I never get accepted into the elites, or if I never have this big rolling bank account, although that would be nice, what's important is I seek Him at the end of the day. Because all those other things will follow. Everything that we desire in our personal life, He cares about that too. But the number one thing He desires out of all of us is to pursue Him with our everything. So I pray that this encourages you as it encourages me, because I'm looking out at the water and I just took the time to just have a little self-care. So I pray that you have a blessed day. Tune in to the blog because there's tons of information, there's tons of encouragement, tons of things that just give you food for thought, just to fuel you throughout the day. So boomforchrist.com, don't forget, share it with a friend. God bless you, I love you, and I'll be talking to you soon.